According to a number of scholars, the Gandhar Grave Complex actually is one of the four principal cultures which document the first use of iron in the South Asian subcontinent. And of course, as you know, that the cultural complex actually extended over a very long period of time, and it is only towards the end that we find the appearance of iron, and that coincides with the period 3 of A.H. Dunny and period 7 of Georgius Thakol. But the date is the same, it lies around 400 to 300 BC. Along this time, we therefore find that the iron had made its first appearance in this part of the subcontinent. There are certain interesting evidences in the form of spearheads, nails, and other things found from different sites. But a very interesting piece has been located at Timargarha, which is a very important site, and that consists of a snaffle bit coming from the cheek piece of a horse's harness. And this has been correlated to some Eurasian finds by Carl Jetmer. It seems that Eurasian finds were related to horse ornaments also, and the dates belong to about 6th to 7th millennium BCE, and these were probably connected with the Indo-Europeans. It may seem to have been connected with this particular Gandhar Grave Complex in the context of South Asian subcontinent.
Ma'am, what is the nature of megalithic complexes in Vindhyan region?
Especially in the southeastern part of the Uttar Pradesh, we find that there is a concentration of megalithic sites, especially in the regions of Allahabad, Banda, Mirzapur and Varanasi. These examples were first discovered by Alexander Cunningham in 1861, and later on they were extensively explored by A.C. Carlyle in 1883, who also identified them as barrows especially. Now, most of the examples are actually cairns and stone circles, and the region is very interesting. The ecologically speaking, this is actually the meeting place of the Ganga Plains into the northern part of the foothills of the Vindhyan Range. And the natural resources for building the megaliths also come from the same area. So ecologically, this is an important niche for the megalithic culture to grow. One thing has to be considered, that this the Vindhyan complex of megaliths are pre-iron. They do not belong to the Iron Age at all. Three different geographical zones have been identified here. The first zone actually is located in the Chandraprabha and Karmanasa river valleys, which comprises the Chakya subdivision in the Varanasi district. And in this particular area, we generally find cairns covering the grave pits, etc. And one of the major sites is Kakoria. And another very interesting fact is that the Vindhyan complexes are also related to habitation sites. For example, at Kakoria, we do have a habitation site associated with the megalithic structures.
Now, ma'am, group 2 is centered around the Chunar region and the northern part of the Mirzapur district, and the geographical zone actually continuing from the Chakia region, and around 400 graves were identified there. And at Panchbahani in Jangal Mahal, 5 grave pits have been discovered, and 3 major types were identified, like the cairns.
Right.
Cairns with slab cysts or chambers, and cairns with enclosing stone circles.
Mm-hmm.
And group 3 of megalithic complex comprised of circular cairns are located near a number of sites near the Rewa Chachai region, and Kotia is one of the primary sites,
right.
And it represents pre-iron megalithic culture. Mm. At Kotia, the graves contain few human skeleton, but it was rather associated with animal burials.
Yes.
And Kotia has a date between 800 BC to 300 BC.
Another thing to note is that, as we have seen, the Vindhya region complexes, megaliths, were belonging to a pre-Iron Age date. But when we come down to Maharashtra, we find that, generally speaking, these are associated with the Iron Age. Archaeological evidence reveals that use of iron first dawned in India around about the 1000 BCE times. Of course, for regular use of iron in productive processes, we have the date of around 600 BCE.